हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज विद्युत विश्वास एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल हिडन जेम्स ऑफ स्टॉक मार्केट बाय विद्युत विश्वास। सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट अ कंपनी नेम गुजरात नर्मदा वैली फर्टिलाइजर एंड केमिकल्स लिमिटेड, एंड इन शॉर्ट इट इज GNFC। आई थिंक यू ऑल नो अबाउट दिस कंपनी। दिस कंपनी इज करेंटली लुकिंग गुड टू मी, दैट्स व्हाई आई वांट टू शेयर फुल टेक्निकल एंड फंडामेंटल एनालिसिस is of this company with you. Friends, I am a technical analyst and don't know much about the fundamental analyst, but whatever the data available at Google, I will share with you. So friends, first I will start with the technical analysis. So first I will go to the chart of the GNFC. See here, it's given a high of the near about 550 at the year of the 2018, and after that it start its correction and see and continuously given high, low, lower high, lower low, again lower high, lower low, again lower high, lower low, again lower high, lower low, or almost equal low or slightly lower low, again lower high, lower low, but here also it's given lower high, but here it's given the higher low. And we all know the high and low indicates that present downtrends and losing its strength or present downtrend weakening. And now see here, slightly here is cause the last high also. You see now if I zoom it out, see here it's caused the last high also. So whenever it will give new high, so that will be higher than this high. So obviously, and we all know that always we are getting higher high at the uptrend only. So we can conclude that after a long downtrend, it's given the signal of the new uptrend. And but we will not conclude with this only with this higher high. We will draw a trend line. Obviously, whenever we will draw the trend line, we will have to cover maximum possible highs. See here, if I will draw a trend line, you see it's broke the trend line also. And see the volume development here, volume buildup here. It's a huge volume buildup here. So it's broken the down trend line and also given breakout over the last high. So this is a very good signal. This is at the initial level of the starting of the new uptrend, and as per technicals, as per say, and volume buildup is also superb. That is a very good positive point, that volume buildup is superb. So now what's the target? It is confirmed that it's started its new uptrend, and now what are the target? So my first target of this company is the old high. So that is the 543, and this is more than almost 3.5 times of the present price. So this is huge target I am giving here. So I am expecting within 2 years it will fulfill, it will come here. But at stock market, we all know that nothing is guaranteed. So always we will have to put a stop loss. So where to put the stop loss? See, I always put a stop loss 3% below of the breakout level. So here is a breakout level is a 149. So 3% below means almost 5 rupees. So I will put a stop loss at 144 at the obviously weekly closing basis, near about this price at the weekly closing basis. If it will close below the 144 weekly closing basis, then I will exit from the stocks, or we will have to close our positions. So this is a looking very good as per me technically, because there are many positive points. It is broke the downtrend line in with a huge volume buildup, and also it's broke the last high, which is a positive sign, because we all know that we are getting higher high at the uptrend only. So with the stop loss of the 144, and those who want to play safe, they can put stop loss below the last low. So that is the 122. So those who want to play safe, they can put stop loss at the 122 weekly closing basis, or those who don't want to take more risks, they can put a stop loss of the 144 at the weekly closing basis. Please remember, it's not daily closing basis, it's weekly closing basis. So this is all about the technical analysis. This is a, as per me, this is a perfect bottom fishing candidate, and we can do bottom fishing here because it's given after the high of the 550, it's corrected up to the near about 96 level, and after that is bouncing back and giving the signal of the new uptrend. So we can do bottom fishing here. Now the fundamental part, friends. I am telling that I am not a fundamental analyst, and whatever the news or information available from Google, I will only share them with you. So the Gujarat Narmada Valley Fertilizers, first we need to know what's the business of Gujarat Narmada Valley Fertilizer and Chemicals Limited. So see here, its business mainly, is the fertilizer, mainly three business is there. One is a fertilizer business, and another one is a chemical business, and others, there is others business. There is mainly neem shop or neem hand wash related products and information technology business. Those are contributing only 2% of their total revenue. They are not significant. Also, significant contribution we are getting from the fertilizer business, that is the 34%, and from the chemical business, that is the 64%. So nowadays we know that chemical segment is booming at India. Everybody is shouting on the chemical segment. Why they are shouting about the chemical segment? Because China are reducing their bulk production due to pollution related issues there. So obviously Indian chemical sector will boom, and nowadays maximum chemical companies are booming. Yes, chemical company stocks are booming. So we expect that this chemical sector, this company's chemical business also will boom, and also fertilizer business. And we all know that India is mainly in farmer means agriculture driven economy. And 16% of its GDP, the GDP depends on the agriculture only. And we all know that this time government is taking many initiatives that rural income can grow. And also they are targeting the doubling the farmers' income up to 2022. So this is with the and if you will. Compare the fertilizer uses per hectare of the land with the developing country and also our neighbors. So we can see that India is using far less compared with the other countries. So there is a scope of growth at India also. And also with the growing population and growing the and urbanization. And so land is also so we obviously increase our production and of agriculture. So with the increasing at the less amount of land, so obviously we will have to increase the use of the fertilizer per hectare length and per hectare length. So and also fertilizer business, we all know that it's depend mainly on the monsoon. Good monsoon obviously increase the use of the fertilizer. So this time the forecast of the good monsoon is there. So we can also see with the increasing of the rural economy, with the growth of the rural economy, with the increasing of the farmers' income, and with the good monsoon, fertilizer business also will boom. And we can now last few days, we can easily check that agrochemicals, those companies are making agrochemicals products, those are booming. Like the Dhanuka Agrotech and Coromandel International, like that. So this company will also boom fertile because due to a fertilizer business. So with the product analysis, we can easily see that fertilizer business and chemical business both are booming in sector of the today. So obviously this company is product wise, this company is good business, main business product wise is very good. So now fertilizer business, GNFC is one of the leaders in fertilizer industries today. The company is engaged in manufacturing and selling of fertilizers such as urea and nitrophosphates under the umbrella of the brand name Narmada GNFC. To its credit, has one of the largest ammonia plant, which is a reference plant in the world on fuel oil based technology, among with the world's largest single steam urea plant. So, and company is also some fertilizer. They are also trading some fertilizer. Those they are not making. The company is engaged in trading of DI ammonia phosphate, DAP and MOP, and single super phosphate SSP and ammonium sulfate, it and city compost. So the basic objective of marketing such fertilizer is to make available wide range of fertilizer to farming community, making regular supplies to fertilizer to distribution channel, and enhancing the company's turnover. The market is undergoing a sea change, and there is a shift from sellers to buyers market. So therefore, it is of paramount importance to make available different type of fertilizer as per the market demand in the different areas. And we at JNFC are more concerned about that. So such steps is help the making the distribution channel more strong, developing good support with them. So see here, they are making mainly urea based fertilizers, but they are trading also. They means they are purchasing other purchases from others, and they are selling, and they are making it available to their sellers and distributors. So they having a huge range of product, and every type of fertilizer is available with their channel. Now their main markets, through the large spread of out networks of dealers, we are available to reach even smaller scale consumer. So they are available at the 1 kg packet to 50 kg packet. So they are available at the larger consumer as well as the those who are making gardening and use consumption is very less to them also. So looking at the importance of the market niche, company thought appropriate to enlarge its market base, keeping the potential of different areas in mind. Gujarat, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and certain parts of Rajasthan are the prime marketing zone of JNFC. And company also markets its fertilizer in the secondary market, which is including Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. So you can imagine a huge portion of the India they are covering with their marketing and distribution channel, with the primary market and also with the secondary market. Narmada Kheruth Kendra are spread over the state of Gujarat at the many location, keep us connected with the farmers. Apart from the advisory on day-to-day agriculture, we provide the best quality of the manufactured and traded fertilizer to the most of the competitive price. So that means with the Narmada Kheruth Sahayak Kendra, with the help of they are advising farmer who is to use and what to use for the agriculture growth, and also they are making available that manufactured fertilizer on traded fertilizer. Now Indian fertilizer mineral, those fertilizer business is not their main business. Only 34% revenue come from the fertilizer business. Still they having 7% market share of the Indian fertilizer business. So that is huge market share they having. 7% market share of the total India is a huge. Those who are not the mainly fertilizer player, they are mainly chemical players, because 64% revenue coming from the chemical business. So now JNFC he has kept pace with the changing time. Its vision always focused on growth. Even as the company was implementing its fertilizer compliance plans, were underway to expansion and diversification is related areas. This resulted in the setting up of core chemical and petrochemical plants such as methanol, formic acid, nitric acid and acetic acid. So they are mainly using making the industrial chemicals. That means methanol, formic acid, nitric acid and acetic acid. This industrial chemical used by the wide range of manufacturer, processor and chemical operators in India, even abroad. So while methanol finds application in chemicals, resins, etc., formic acid mainly used by the rubber, textile, tanneries, and pharmaceutical industries. So both methanol and formic acid are regularly being exported to international market also. So they are actually their chemical products are the very basic chemicals products and industrial chemicals. Those are used at the wide range of application, and they are selling it as the domestic market as well as international markets also. And we all, and there are other business include only 2% contribution of the other business. There is a very small portion of the IT business. And also this year there is a huge range of product of the Narmada Neem product. So Narmada Neem and making generally mainly hand wash. See, a huge range of products is available at the name of the Narmada Neem. Maybe it may be huge at one day, but now today all these products, I mean Narmada Neem hand wash, Narmada Neem oil, Narmada Neem shampoo, Narmada Neem hair oil, Narmada Neem night, and GNFC Neem face wash. So all are the available at the brand name of the Narmada Neem, and all products are available. I checked at the is Amazon, Flipkart, India Mart, and eBay at all e-commerce platform is at the available. This may be one day. This may be huge at the FMCG platform because they are being a huge range of product at the brand of Narmada Neem. And Neem, when the Neem names comes, this is a big name at the India because Neem means organic, and after the COVID situation, obviously organic type of this type of natural product use will be huge. So now something about the some positive point. And now we all know that this year monsoon forecast is good, and with the good monsoon forecast, obviously fertilizer company will boost, and rural development with the government focus on the rural economy development obviously help this type of company and this company's debt-free status. So see, the at the year of the 2014 is having debt almost 400 crore, and after that from the 2016-17 also it having all more than 200 crore debt. But right now at the September 2019 it's having debt only 15 crore. So it reduces its debt substantially. That means its profit will increase because it's whatever the operating profit it will convert to the after tax, it will convert to the PAT, means profit after tax, because they will not have any interest cost then. So obviously then profit will increase, obviously, because see here at this time we all know that the 2017 there is a price of the 550. So that time also they are having a huge debt of the 2000, more than 2000 crore. So with the more than 2000 crore debt, so they obviously they are paying interest. So that is huge. So now see here, their market share is not changing. Their sales also not changes. Almost it's equal. In fact, it's growth from the 2017 to right now. So 2017 is near about 3,500 crore sales. Right now it is at 4,800. And it's almost similar with the 2019 and 2020. There is no change. But only change is there now. They are debt-free company, almost debt-free company. Once at the 2015, they having the 4,000 crore debt, and they having now only 56 crore debt. So debt is reduced substantially. So there is interest cost will be reduced. So obviously profit will increase. And if profit will increase, obviously this will give you more dividend and more benefit to the its shareholders. So obviously price will increase with the debt-free status, and we can see the stock is providing good dividend yield of the 4.51%. You can imagine this is a Gujarat state government PSU, and it's given a huge dividend. That the dividend yield is a 4.51, and company having also good consistent profit of the 20.61 over the past 5 years. So we can conclude that from angle of the technical, it is very good. It is at the perfect bottom fishing condition, and with the good volume buildup, and also fundamental point of view, they are having a huge range of fertilizers. They are making urea and also trading all range of fertilizer under the brand name of the Narmada GNFC. And also they are having the major, they are making the bulk chemicals, mean industrial chemicals, and they are selling it at the domestic market as well as the international market. Also, they now with the good monsoon forecast and rural economy development, everything is positive for this company. So I am huge positive of this company. So friends, you can use my analysis for your learning purpose only. If you want to take position at this company, please take the help of the financial advisor, discuss with financial advisor or do your own analysis, because I am not a SEBI registered analyst. So I can't give you any mixed recommendation. So this is, friends, this is all about the analysis of my on the GNHC. So friends, if it is good, please like and share with others and spread my video with all. Friends, this is all about the GNFC. Bye-bye.